In this video, we will see data acquisition and device control block. This is the library tree and these are the library function where different types of logic blocks are available. This is the way where we can insert the particular logic block in control module. Now we will see the analog data acquisition block. The purpose of this data acquisition block is to scale and alarm the particular analog input. For that we need to add some block pins. Here you can see PVHHFL. PV high alarm. PV LL alarm, which is low alarm, and PV low alarm. These are the output processing flags. Now we will set the alarm. This is the alarm page where we can set the particular alarm. Now first of all we will give the high value to 80%, this to the 20% low value, low value to 10%, and high value to 90%. Now here there are priorities, different priority. Journal, low, high, urgent, depending on the criticality of that input, we need to select the priority. So we will select the urgent. Whichever you configure the priority for particular alarm, it will be definitely come in the alarm list. Now here you can give the particular name, description, engineering unit. Here auto mode, or you can select the manual mode also. We will set the only auto mode. PV format, which is the 2 decimal, determines 2 decimal. PV characterization, at one point we will select the linear. Press OK. We will copy the particular block and paste. For pasting you need to press the Ctrl V. Here it is asking the new name, so we will not edit that particular name, we will keep as it is. In this particular function block, instead of linear we will set the square root. Whenever there is a, we will save the particular CM. Whenever there is a flow calculation, at that time we will set the square root in either DCS or in field. So let's say we have set that particular square root format in DCS. This is the numeric output board, output block, where we can provide the percentage of input. Now let's say this is the particular pressure type. Again we will add one output flag, bad PV alarm. Bad PV alarm dot FL. Now we will save and download the particular CM. Here is the logic. Now as I said, the input is bad since it is getting the not a number value, so bad PV alarm is in alarm state. Now let's say we have given the 25%, So you can see the bad PVLM is gone. Now 25 is converted in the format of 0 to 100. If there is the range of 0 to 200 at that time, we will get the 25% of 200, means 50 value here. So since it is the 0 to 100 at that time, we are getting the 25% to 25%. This is the linear format, and here you can see the output is 50. Here we have set the PV characterization as square root. So in this way, this particular data acquisition block scales the output. Now let's see, the process input is 81. As we have given the process input as 81, at that time PV high alarm is appear. Let's say we will provide the 92%. So at 92% PV high alarm flag is activated. So this flag can be used at the process where we need to provide the particular tripping or any alarming condition. And once it goes again down, let's say 5, at that time both the alarms are normalized, high end high high and low end low low alarm is appeared. From this output blacks, we can provide the tripping to the particular pump or drum, boiler, etc. So next we will modify the range, where you will get the knowledge how it is scaling. Let's say the particular range is 200, 150, and here also we will set the 150. Save and download. It is giving the alarm limit or range crossover. We will check that one. Here extended high limit is not provided, we need to provide it as 160. Since high value is 150, high value must be more than that one. You can put 151 also. So these are the runtime errors which occurs during the download, and we need to find out what is the alarm the CM is giving and accordingly sort that particular error. Now it will, sure it will complete the download. Okay, finish. So here again bad PV alarm is acted. Now we will give the 25. Now you can see we have given the 25% of input, and it is showing the 37.5%, which is 25% of this full scale range, which is 150. And here also for square root value, 25% means 50% of output. So 50% of 150 is 75, so it is giving the 75% of output. So in this way, data acquisition blocks is scaled in DCS and also provide the alarm flags for the tripping of particular devices or boiler. Thank you.